you and I, we have both talked to a lot of players who had chances to move from the Liga MX to Europe, and they kept pointing fingers at owners by saying the price tag is too expensive. In these specific cases, who's to blame for this player staying in Liga MX and not making the jump to European soccer?
Listen, I've been very critical of Mexican ownerships of Liga MX and that internal, that very inflated internal market. And I'm still very critical at that. But at some point, we need to look at the player. We need to look at the ambitions of the player. There's a reason Tecatito Corona is legendary in Liga MX. And I mean legendary within players in the Players Association, because he held to his guns. He stuck to him and he said, I'm not signing. And he went by himself and went to Europe and signed. And this is how the legend of Tecatito Corona grew. Orbelin Pineda just did that. This is what you need to do nowadays, is to put your foot down, take a stand, and leave yourself saying no. Guess what? I don't want to take your millions. I know you're going to pay me more. Alexis Vega, Chivas player, he might get paid twice as much as he made last season for scoring zero goals last season because they don't want to lose him to Europe. At some point, the player needs to say, I want this. And if you want Liga MX, there's nothing wrong with that. But don't go the Luis Romo route and for the better part of a year say it's Europe or bust, and all of a sudden, oh, wait a second, Monterrey sounds nice. Yeah, I'll take those dollars.
Okay, I don't buy that 100%, and here's why. Let me check the clock. 55 minutes ago, on this very same show, we were celebrating the fact that a homegrown player, MLS player, was worth or is worth $20 million, right? Ricardo Pepi transferred to Augsburg for $20 million. Because you're saying Tecatito Corona is a hero. Gerardo Torrado, in his time, he did the exact same thing, right? Orbelin Pineda not renewing his deal with Cruz Azul. Awesome. That's the only way to go to Europe. No. Augsburg just paid $20 million. Why can't Mexican teams find ways to profit from what they do with young players and sell them like FC Dallas just did with Ricardo Pepi? Why is it okay and we celebrate Ricardo Pepi and his transfer for $20 million, and then you keep asking Mexican players to, hey, man, play the hero. Don't sign a new deal and go on a free transfer to Europe.
You're misinterpreting like you did with Sebastian Jovinko. I'm not celebrating Ricardo Pepi leaving.
That's
celebrating that somebody
thinks
a player for Major League Soccer is worth $20 million with under 60 games. That is really astonishing to me. That is the celebration part. If he wants to stay, stay. Okay. If they want to stay, stay. The thing is, these players, if they really want to get to the next level, and you know this in Mexican soccer, you could score 4 goals a season and make $1 million. Okay? That's not going to make you a better player.
And it's going to
make you a more
MLS,
richer
by the way.
Person. It may not happen unless, or it may. Ricardo Pepi got a deal for a higher salary, just to increase the transfer fee. It's something that we've seen since the Eddie Johnson days back in the day in Major League Soccer. What I'm trying to tell you right now is, and I do not agree with you, because if you want to see Mexico get to the second round every World Cup, and that's as far as they go, keep doing what you're doing. That's fine, okay? If you want to see the U.S. get to maybe the second round or maybe make a run at the quarterfinal, keep doing what you're doing. But if you want to see them compete for World Cups, if you want to see them be the best that they can possibly be, have them try to play at the highest level possible, not domestically, not in Liga MX, not in Major League Soccer, that's not where you want them. You want them sharpening that iron. You want them in the best level possible.
I will keep scratching my head trying to figure out why Mexican players need a free transfer to make the jump, and why.
Because nobody's going to pay what they're asking.
And why a player like Ricardo Pepi is actually worth $20 million with so
little experience. He's an 18-year-old who scores goals for the national team, and he scored goals in his first season.
As you just mentioned.
And he's 18 years old. How many young Mexican players get an opportunity in Mexico?
You have El Chaquito Jiménez at Cruz Azul. Chaquito Jiménez at Cruz Azul. They have just won a bronze medal at the Olympics.
Yes, youth national.
The under 17 team has won the World Cup twice in the past 15 years. So there's talent.
Keep doing what you're doing, because that's exactly what's going to get you the same thing. Nobody's denying that there's talent, Mal.
We'll see.
I'm telling you, the internal market is so messed up that nobody will touch it. Rojo Pizarro was valued at $20 million 2 years ago.
Well,
he ended up at Inter Miami.
And now he's back at Rayados de Monterrey.